Hi, Stefan Svartling here from Svartling Network. Samsung has announced a new Galaxy Alpha, a new Android smartphone that looks a bit nicer than earlier Galaxy phones, and it will probably feel a bit better in your hand, not so plastic as before, because of the new metallic frame. But it's still no unibody design though. It's an ultra-thin phone, not only 6.7mm thick. And it uses a 4.7-inch Super AMOLED display, and that's not so strange because Samsung is the only one that uses AMOLED nowadays. And the display has a 720p resolution, and the phone will either come with an octa-core Exynos chip or a quad-core chip, depending on where you live. And the phone has 2GB of RAM and 32GB of internal memory, but no SD card slot. And the phone has a 12 megapixel rear camera and a 2.1 millimeter front facing camera. And the battery is kinda small for an Android phone, only 1860 milliampere battery, and that is kinda small. Android drains the battery quite a lot. And it has LTE, of course, and Bluetooth, and only USB 2.0. That's a bit strange. Why not USB 3.0? And it has the fingerprint sensor and a heart rate sensor as the Galaxy S5. And it runs Android 4.4.4 KitKat. And the phone will be available in the beginning of September, says Samsung, in either black, white, gold, silver, or blue. Personally, I still think it's kind of obvious that Samsung releases this phone before Apple announces the new iPhone 6, and it will have the same screen size as the rumored iPhone 6. So it's kind of obvious that Samsung tries to take some new users, customers from Apple with a smaller Android phone. They usually release much bigger phones. And the metallic frame, yes, it makes this phone looks a bit better and have a more luxurious design. But it still has the same plastic backside, removable backside. So not so huge difference. I think if you look at the phone from the sides, it looks a bit like the iPhone 5S with the same sharped edges and so on. And from the front of it, it looks very much like an iPhone, but instead of a Touch ID button, it has a oval button, a squared button, home button. And the rest of the phone looks more or less like a normal Galaxy phone, no huge difference. But I must say that this is a step forward for Samsung. It looks better than before, I admit that. But I don't know yet how much bloat it is on it and how the TouchWiz is on this phone, but hopefully Samsung has cleaned up that mess too. Hopefully. Okay, please like this video. Bye!